Okay, let's do an example when we have data being the summary, being some summary statistics, which is related to the sample size. So let's get into the data. Now, remember that I have already set my working space here. So we can directly read the data in. So I read the data in and let's take a look what it's like. This is the number of years of experience, and this is the corresponding sample size. And I mean, for each of the category, like for professor have no experience, we have collected 17 data points, and the third quartile of the 17 data points being experience being zero as this value. So those are the data for this set. And years of experience being there and sample size of that group and third quartile of the pay of that group. So this is our Y value, the third quartile. And our X is the years of experience. And we know the sample size corresponding to each group. So we'll do a regular least square and the weighted least square and use the sample size as weight when we do the WLS. Let's just do it the regular least square and the weighted least square, and I specify the weight being sample size, right? And now, well, I have plotted here, but let's just redo it. This is the data, like y here, x being here, and we add our regression line. This is least square line, the regular one, and let's add the line from WLS, the weighted least square, denoted by this blue line. Slightly different. I'll add the legend to denote this black line is for least square, this blue line is for weighted least square. Now let's find the predicted salary for x equal to 6. Use this WLS. So this is how do I do it? I do predict with this WLS model and provide the new data being a data frame with only this one value, experience equal to 6. So this is my predict. So this is my prediction. Okay, let's do a prediction interval now. We'll first try to use our usual way. We are supposed to give us a warning about the prediction variance. So how do we do that? How do we do the prediction interval correctly? So apparently this is not the right one because it assuming constant prediction variance, even though the fit is weighted. Let's use the least square fitting trick where we like transform everything and do the regular LM least square model with the transformed x1, x2, and also the new y value. And there's no intercept in this new model. Let me see this. So this is transform the y, and this is remove the intercept, and this is transform the x1, and this is our new x2. Let's just fit this model. And to get the prediction, we need both the new value for x, which is 6, experience equal to 6, and the sample size. Remember, we would have to transform it back to the original scale of y. So here, It's easier to read. Yeah, so this is something you might realize when you work in the industry. There is a recommended format for R coding that it's like, yeah, like the number of I think it's the length of your coding in one line. And also like for this type of operations, you would have to have a space or things like that. So yeah, when you work in industry, you will know, that it's better to write your code in a certain format. Well, anyway, let's come back to our prediction. So when we do the prediction, I have this for the predict function, where I use this model, and the new data I have to provide is both this x value and the sample size. So in this way, I can get the prediction interval, and also we have to transform it back. Remember, if we have like the sample size equals to 25, and because we have multiplied everything by the square root of 25, which is like the square root of, square root of 25, that's fine. So so this is after the transformation, we get our interval. So the fit is the same as previously. Yeah, and this is the interval we have. This is just a comparison, that what if I have this sample size being 5 instead of 25, and see what it looks like. So let's just compare with the previous one. So this one is giving you a much wider prediction interval because we have a smaller sample size. So this is just to show you sample size matters in this case. That's it for this file.